Do you have an external drive that won't mount on your Mac? It could be a drive malfunction, connectivity issues, or even a random error with your Mac itself. But whatever the case, today I'm going to show you how to solve all of these issues. And by the way, if this video helps you out and your drive starts working again, hit the subscribe button down below for more recovery tip videos just like this one. But after this video, if you're still stuck, leave a comment down below letting me know, and we might be able to help you out in a pinch. Okay, so let's start with one of these simpler methods to fix an external hard drive that won't mount on a Mac, which is checking for connection issues. And this is especially relevant for MacBooks, as sometimes they can partition their power, which can give them issues with their onboard ports. The first thing to consider is a lack of power to your drive, which can happen if your MacBook is running on battery power and every USB port is in use. If there are too many things connected to your Mac or your Mac is low on battery, it can cause connection issues. So to rule this out, disconnect everything that's not essential and plug your Mac into power from the wall and check to see if the problem persists. Now, if this doesn't solve it, the second thing to check is the actual connection itself. Be sure to try connecting your external hard drive using different USB cables, different ports, different USB hubs, or a different power supply. Check all the physical connections and be sure the fault actually lies with the drive itself. Now, after we verify that connectivity isn't the issue, the next thing we should do is to restart our Mac. Sometimes there are little errors and things that only a restart can fix, so doing that quickly as our next step is important to rule those out. Alright, now the next thing we should check is to ensure that the partition on our drive is mounted correctly. Now, it is possible for our drive not to mount in Finder, but for the partition to actually still mount successfully, which indicates that all of our files are intact. And we can confirm this by using Disk Utility. First, open a Finder window, then navigate to Applications, Utilities, then Disk Utility. Click the View button in the toolbar, and select Show All Devices. Next, expand your drive in the sidebar to see all the partitions and APFS containers by clicking the little triangle icon next to it. Then select the partition or APFS container you want, and if the partition isn't mounted, then you'll see a mount button in the toolbar, and you can click it to verify that it really can't be mounted manually. But if you see an unmount button, then it means the partition is actually mounted already, and we can move on. Now, if the partition does appear to be mounted correctly inside of Disk Utility, but you still get errors like the drive is raw or it's unformatted, then it's likely the file system is corrupted. Additionally, if Disk Utility gives you no other information or feedback about a drive and it still can't be mounted, then it's very likely that it's actually physically damaged, at which point you should contact a professional recovery service, especially if you still cannot mount an external drive on your Mac. But if you just have the error that the drive is raw or needs to be formatted before use, then we can still fix it. We just have to deploy some more invasive solutions to actually fix the problem. But before we do that, we actually need to recover all the data off the drive so that we don't lose anything in the process. And the software we're going to be using to do this is called Disk Drill. Disk Drill is able to access the data on a corrupt hard drive and safely recover it and bypass errors even if the drive appears raw, unformatted, or with other signs of a damaged file system. And it works with all external hard drives, whether you're using a Samsung, Lacy, Seagate, etc. It's got you covered. So let's get started. To recover files from an external drive that is not mounting on a Mac, first download and install Disk Drill onto your Mac. Next, once it's installed, ensure your external drive is connected to your Mac and open Disk Drill, and you'll be presented with the disk list, a list of all drives connected to your Mac. Now, a note I should make here is that if you're working with a corrupted drive, it would be best to create a backup using the byte-to-byte backup feature and then import that into Disk Drill for scanning instead of scanning the drive itself. This is the safest way to conduct a scan in that case. And if you need more information on this method, I will link a video that explains the whole thing in detail down below in the description. However, for most applications, all we have to do is select our drive in the center and hit search for lost data. Now, as our drive scans, you will begin to see files populate in the center as colored categories, which is how you know you're making progress. And once the scan is done, you can review all the files that were found using the button in the top right corner of the screen. Now, here you can navigate through the files and view all that was recovered by Disk Drill. You can also use features such as icon view and recovery chances to get a solid idea of which files are completely intact and able to be recovered in full. Now, what I'm going to do is recover all of the files from my drive. So I'm going to check the box at the very top of the file structure. However, if you only want certain files, you can mark them individually as well using a check mark. Next, hit recover in the bottom right and choose your save location. And it's important to note here that your save location is separate from your external drive, which will prevent overwriting. Finally, hit next, and this will export all of your recovered files to your save location. Okay, so now that we've recovered our files and they're totally safe, we can use a few other methods to try and restore our drive's functionality. And the first thing we can use is back in Disk Utility using the First Aid tool. Navigate back to Disk Utility in your applications, select your drive from the list, and hit the First Aid button in the menu bar. Then hit Run. This will start the process, the end of which will give a summary of what was done and whether or not the problem was resolved. Now another thing we can try, it's a little more technical, but it's to reset our Mac's NVRAM or PRAM and the SMC. These are controllers on Intel-based Macs that are responsible for the smooth functioning of several processes, including the function of external drives. And when these malfunction, they can cause all kinds of minor issues, including drive mounting problems. Luckily though, it's very easy to fix. We can reset it very easily by doing the following. First, for NVRAM or PRAM, power down your Mac, then turn it on again and immediately hold P, R, Option, and Command together until you see the Apple logo or hear the startup sound twice. At that point, release the keys and let your Mac restart as normal. For SMC, shut down your Mac, press Left Control, Left Command, and Right Shift together for about 7 seconds. Next, press and hold the power button in addition for another 7 seconds. So you're holding all four keys together. Release all the keys and wait a few seconds. Then power on your Mac as normal. And once your Mac powers on again, reconnect your drive and see if it will connect. All right, now if all else has failed at this point, the only thing left to do is to format our drive. Now this will of course erase all of the data on our drive, but because we've recovered all of our files ahead of time, this isn't an issue. And so here's how you can fix your external hard drive not mounting on a Mac by formatting. Go back to Disk Utility once more, select your drive from the list, hit Erase in the top bar, then choose a name for your drive, and if you're unsure about the other parameters, simply leave those as default, and hit Erase. Now this will completely erase the drive and reset the file system, and the drive should reconnect again after it's complete. But that's gonna do it. That is how you fix an external hard drive not mounting on your Mac. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and you got something out of it. If you did, leave a like down below and leave a comment letting me know what you guys wanna see next and what you guys need help with. But until then, I will see you soon with something new.